procedure, policies in terms of how many schools required, catchment population, how much, and all these things. So this is the, this is supposed to be the balance. Now, when the plan came out first, everybody, many members of the public objected, gave their feedback, and I went for at least six to nine hearings, and the hearing committee was quite good. I talked about green space calculation, how many square meters per person, all that, and everything was done, all finished. So the plan is going to be passed and implemented. And the problem is, since the hearings have been closed, changes are being made without going through the public process of amending the plan. And these are changing the equation which we are talking about. It's catering for high density compact development, which is not in the plan. You're getting here 800 persons per acre. The plan, even on class 3 residents, 400 persons maximum in certain areas. So basically, all these matters, that's why it cost 30 million ringgit, went through this study with the top people, universities, all involved, and there's a reluctance to want to pass it. And if not 1 year, 2 year, it's coming up in 15, 16 years. So in the 16 years, all kinds of approvals have been given, which contradict this plan, and has made it a mess. And that's why we are saying today's topic, is it a world-class mess? Not yet, but it's on the way to carry on with ad hoc development without a plan. Next question. Please ask any question you want to ask. Any question, I'll answer it. Yes.
Good evening. Chair, fellow lawmakers and cabinetists. I have made some observations. I would like to seek the comments of these lawmakers and Mr. Fernandez himself. Yes, we are talking about sending a petition opposing seeking for a compelling answer or compelling the Federal Treasury Minister or DBKL to gazette this KLCT plan. My observation in so far is, yes, you can do that, but there has been a modus operandi from the slides shared in so far, that there seems to be a trend of alienation here. If you look at KL, the process, alienation process is done by the Federal Territory Board, Jawatan Kuasa Kerja Tanah, Wilayah Persekutuan. And this Jawatan Kuasa is directly under the Federal Territory Ministry. And the modus operandi I'm talking about is the alienation is being done to at least two Yayasan Wilayah Persekutuan, where the Federal Territory Minister is the chairperson or the pengerusi, followed by his fellow comrades. One is in Taman Desa, and one is in Taman Titi Wangsa. And worst case in the, I'm sorry, Taman Desa is DBKR themselves is the owner, and TTEI, Yayasan Wilayah Persekutuan. So, lawmakers question this alienation process. In your petition, don't only ask for the gazettement of this KLCT plan, also question, do a statistic study of all the alienation done to Yayasan Wilayah Persekutuan and question the, how did you get land? And also public land. You are not getting any private land, you are getting sewage land, padang, open space. Question it. My observation is about what you have to say, Mr. Fernandez.
In fact, I question this about what is Yayasan Wilayah Persekutuan, what is the function, and what them nicely in parliament. Then Tengku Anan is the first class Tai Chi player. You know, he will and then he will say that, oh, you know, this Yayasan will help the poor, help the marginalized, and now they use the excuse that like Derek say, rumah week, you know. So a lot of houses in KL are getting more expensive. So he explained that, you know, that the SA calendar, why did we give them so many pieces of land? It's because they built rumah week, the affordable houses. They use that as excuse. So they allow the developer to go up to 50 storey and 51 storey, that kind of nonsense. So it's something very difficult for us to counter it. As long as you don't have power, you say whatever, they just allow you to say whatever you like in they want right. Yeah. We all like sitting there so miserable, we all feeling the pain and we can't do much.